Hello friends, in last video we were talking about BCD to hex and hex to BCD assembly language program. We have discussed BCD to hex assembly language program in my last video. In this video we will discuss hex to BCD assembly language program. This was our problem statement, and for this problem statement we have already implemented this hex to BCD, and now we will see BCD to hex. The same program I am using because it is a menu driven program, and out of this menu, first menu we have discussed, and now it's time for second menu, BCD to hex. Again, program execution will start from here, start. Okay, so by this this is our array we have, and these are different data items which we have discussed in last video also. Start, so move ax comma at the rate data, move ds comma ax, it will be initialization of data segment. Then menu, display message 7893. So it will display menu BCD to hex, hex to BCD, exit and enter your choice. So by reading this message, enter your choice, user will enter one choice. Let's say in this case user enters 2. So move ah comma 01h int 21h. This instruction will read choice entered by user and will save this number into AL register. So ASCII value of 2 is 32. So AL register will contain number 32 hex. Move BL comma AL. Whatever is in AL 32, that will be moved to BL register. Compare BL comma 31 hex. Compare it with 31 hex to check whether the choice entered by user is 1. Jump if not equal to next. So in this case BL contents of BL are 32, which is not equal to 31, so it will jump to next. That means it will come here. Compare BL with 32. Now compare BL with 32. Jump if not equal to last, but in this case they are equal, so this instruction will be skipped and control will come here, call BH2. Now it will call procedure BH2. So control will be transferred to BH2 procedure. BH2 procedure starts from here. So first instruction of BH2 will be executed, display message 5. So enter hex number. This is the message which will be displayed on the screen. Next instruction, move cx comma 0404h. So 0404h will be moved to cx register. Move dx comma 000h. 000h will be moved to dx register. Move ah comma 01h int 21h. Again, by reading this message, enter hex number, user will enter one hexadecimal number. Let's say a number entered by user is 1234. So to read this number, we will use this instructions. Move ah comma 01h int 21h. It will read first number and it will store that number in AL register in its ASCII value. Okay, so one ASCII value of one is 31. Now again, like we have checked whether the BCD entered by user is valid BCD or not, here also we will check whether number entered by user is valid hexadecimal number or not. So valid hexadecimal number means it should contain values from 0 to 9 and characters from A to F. So it can be small a to F or capital A to F, whatever. Okay, so to check this, we will compare this number with 30. If it is below 30, it means it is not a valid hex number, because ASCII value below 30 doesn't mean it is a number or a A to F. So jump if below to invalid. So invalid, again it will just simply display message invalid entry and return. It will return to the main program. But in this case it is greater than 30. Okay, so compare AL comma 39. Compare it with 39. If it is greater, next 6. Greater than 39 means it can be a character A to F. So we have to check whether it is in between small A to F. So the ASCII values of small A to F are from 41 to 46. So we have to check whether the number or the ASCII value is from 41 to 46 hex. And if not, it is invalid. But if it is greater than 46, it means that number or the character entered by user is in capital letter. So it can be capital A to capital F. So ASCII values of capital A to F are 61 to 66. If it is in between 61 to 66, then it is okay. But if it is less than 66 or greater, less than 61 or greater than 66, then again invalid. Okay. Now, if the number hex number is between 0 to 9, then we have to subtract 30 from the number to convert it into its original value. If it is between small a to f, then we have to subtract 37 from the number to get the original value. And if it is from 61 to 66, that means if it is from capital A to capital F, then we have to subtract 57 to get its original value. Okay. So now here it is 31. 31 means it will come here greater, it's not greater, so subtract AL comma 30. So 30 will be subtracted, so AL will contain 01 and jump to below. Here also same, jump to below. Okay, so it will directly come here. Okay. Hope you understand this. Once the number is entered, it will be checked whether it is between 0 to 9. If not, if it is between A to F. If not, if it is between capital A to capital F. That's it. And if the number entered by user is correct, it will come here. Rotate left DX comma CL. So now in this case DX contains 0000. Rotate this left by 4 bits because CL contains 4 bits. Rotate left by 4 bits. It will be same 0000. Move AH comma 00. So by moving 00 to AH and by combining AH and AL, we will get AX as 0001. This is AH, first two digits AH 00, and this was our previous AL 01. Then next, add DX comma AX. This 0001 plus this 000 will give you 0001. So this one has come here. Okay, 10. Then decrement CH, as we have done with the first digit, decrement CH. So CH will become 03. Jump if not 0 to back 6. So as this is not 0, we will go back 6 means here, and it will read the next number. Okay, it will read the next number and it is 2. So 2, ASCII value of 2 is 32, so 32 will be stored in AL register. Again it is checked whether it is in between 0 to 9, capital A to small a to f, capital F to a, all the things, and then by looking at this, 30 will be subtracted, so it will become 2. Okay, next instruction is rotate left by 4 bits. So dx will be rotated by 4 bits, So the one which was previously here in this position will come here. Okay, rotate left by 4 bits, and now we have to add dx, ax. So this ax is 0002 by moving ah 000. 0002 plus this 0010 will give you this 2 here. Okay, so this 1 was previously here, rotate left and add this. So 0012. Okay, this 2 added here. So 0012. Okay, then decrement CH. Again, CH will be decremented by 1, 2, and jump if not 0 to back 6. Again, it will go up and it will read next number. Next number is 3. So, AL register will contain 33. Again, 33 minus 30, it will give you 3. Now, again, rotate left DX, this instruction. Rotate left DX. So, now 1 from here will come here and 2 from here will come here. So, it will be 1, 2 and 0. Now, AH 00, it will make AX 0003. Now, add these two numbers, DX and AX will give you 1, 2, 3. Okay. Just we are converting this hexadecimal number into BCD means we are representing each digit into its binary. That's it. Okay. Then again decrement CH by 1. CH is decremented by 1. It is not 0. So go up. It will read 4th digit, that is 4. AL is 34 minus 30. It will give you 4. Now rotate left. See, it is 0, 1, 2, 3. After rotating left, it will be 1, 2, 3 and 0. Okay. Now, add AX 00, it will make AX 0004. 0004 plus this DX, 4 will come here. So, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So, now, again, decrement CX. Now, CH is 00. So, jump if not 0, back 6, it will not go here. It will come here. Move OP1, DX. So, whatever is in DX, this 1, 2, 3, 4 will be moved to OP1. So, OP1 will contain exactly same value. Display message 6. It will display message 6. It's the equivalent BCD number is. Now we have to display the equivalent BCD number. Okay, so this is means these 4 bits represent 1, this 4 bit represents 2, this 4 bits represent 3, and this 4 bits represent 4. Now we have to display its equivalent decimal value, okay, which we have seen in previous video also. We have to represent this in decimal. Move AX, OP1. So, whatever is in OP1 will be moved to AX. So, this is 1, 2, 3, 4 hexadecimal. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 hexadecimal. Then, move DX, 000H. Again, DX is made 0. Move BX, 000A. BX is 000A. 000A means 10. We have seen in previous video for logic, we have to divide this number by 10 to get each digit separately. Okay? Because we cannot print directly answer 4 digit, 5 digit answer on the screen. We have to display digits one by one. So, how it will be done? We divide the number by 10 and we represent that number by printing each digit separately. Move BX, 000A. A means 10. We are going to divide the number by 10. Now, next instruction is divide BX. So, when this instruction is executed, what happens? See, divide BX. DX colon AX divided by bx, divide bx instruction, dx colon ax divide by bx. Bx is 16 bit register. So divide bx means dividend should be 32 bit and divisor bx is a 16 bit. So dx combined with ax divided by bx. So here dx is 0, ax is this 1, 2, 3, 4 means 4660 in decimal. If you convert this binary number into decimal, you will get number as 4600. After this division, quotient will be in AX register and remainder will be in DX register. Okay. So, when this instruction is executed, divide BX, see, DX colon AX means 0 appended with 4600 previously, 0 appended with 4600 divided by 10 means simply 4600 divided by 10. So now quotient is 466 and remainder is 0. So after execution of this instruction, quotient will be in AX 466, remainder will be in DX 0. Okay. Now next instruction is push DX. So now DX contains the remainder and we are going to push this remainder onto stack. So this simply push DX. So whatever are the contents of DX, that will be pushed onto stack. Next, increment count. Count will be incremented by 1. As we have pushed one element onto stack, we are incrementing count by 1. Compare AX with 00. We will repeat this process, dividing and pushing remainder onto stack till we get 00 in this AX register. Okay. So compare AX with 000. It is not 000. So jump if not 0 to up. Up means again here. So what is the instruction? Again make DX 0000, make DX 000, make BX 10. Okay. Then again divide BX. So now in this case 466 divided by 10. Okay. 466 divided by 10 will give you quotient 46 and remainder 6. So this is quotient 46, remainder 6. Next instruction, push DX. It will push this 6 onto stack. So 6 will be on stack. Increment count, as we have pushed second element onto stack, increment count, count will be 2. Compare AX with 00. It is not 00, so go up. Again, move DX, 00. DX is again, because whenever division will be made, it will be made with DX colon AX. So it is necessary to make DX 000. Okay. DX 000, BX, 10, then divide BX. Now 46 divided by 10 will give you quotient 4 and remainder 6. See here. Quotient 4 and remainder 6. Remainder will be pushed onto stack and count will be incremented by 1. Count is 3. Now, still AX is not 00. Compare AX, 00. AX is not 00. So, again go up. DX, move DX, 00. Make DX 0. Make BX 10. Now, 4 divided by 10. Now AX will be, means quotient will be 0 and remainder will be 4. So after this instruction, quotient is 0, remainder is 4. This 4 will be pushed onto stack. So 4 will come here and count will be incremented by 1. Count is 4. So now see this, this count will be used at the time of printing. We must know how many elements are there in the stack. That's why this is count, that this count is used. Now AX is 00, so compare AX with 00, jump if not 0 to up. this will not be executed. Compare AX with 00, so it will come directly here. Okay, pop DX. So pop DX means pop element from the stack. Now you all know the stack operation, so the topmost element will be popped up, and pop DX means the popped up value will be stored in DX register. So after popping operation, 4 will be popped, and that 4 will be stored in DX register. Okay, then add DL comma 30. Again we have to print 4, we cannot print directly 4, we have to convert it into ASCII value. So add 30, it will become 34. Move AH comma 0 to INT 21H. Again this instruction, INT 21H will read code from AH. What is there in AH? 02. 02 means write content on the screen, the value which is stored in DL, or stored in DX register. So 4 will be printed, 34, 34 is the ASCII value for 4, so 4 will be printed. Next, decrement count. As we have popped up one element, decrement count, count will become 3. Count is not 0, jump if not 0 to back 6. Jump if not 0 to back 5. Back 5 means come here, pop up the element 6. It will be copied to DX register, add 30, it will be 36. Again move AH comma 0 to INT 21H, print that number on the screen, and 36 is the ASCII value for 6. So 6 will be printed, then count will be decremented by 1. Again pop the element, store it in DX, add 30, print the element. Count is decremented by 1, and pop the element, pop it to DX, add 30, print it. 30 is the ASCII value of 0, so 0 will be printed, and count will be decremented by 1, it will be 00. Now count is 00, so jump if not 0 back 5, it will not go to back 5, it will execute this instruction return. Return means it will return to the return from where procedure is called. So procedure was called from main function here, and with option 2, call BH2. Okay, so it will come to this instruction, jump menu. So it will again jump to menu, means it will come here, and again menu will be displayed. Menu BCD 2 hex, hex to BCD, exit, enter your choice. Now consider that by reading this, user enters 3, because now user has to exit from the program. User will enter 3. 3 means AL register will contain 33. Because of this two instruction, it will read 3, and the number will be moved to AL register, that is 33. So compare it with 31, it is not 31, go to next. Compare it with 32, it is not 32, so jump if not equal to last. Last means it will come here, move AH comma 4CH INT 21H. This is to just the hold screen, means it will wait until user enters something or user presses any key from the keyboard. Again these two instructions also we have discussed earlier, move AH comma 4CH INT 21H. 4CH function is used to get a character from keyboard. This is to hold the screen till you enter any and press any key, because you have to see the result, final result, that's why. Okay, so it will come to last, it means it will execute this instruction, and when user presses any key, it will come out of the output screen. And this is end start, means here our main procedure ends, and end means our program ends here. Okay. Thank you. This is all about hexadecimal to BCD conversion. Okay. Hope you understand the logic. Thank you for watching my videos. If you like my videos, press the like button given below the video. You can ask me your queries through comment section given below. Thank you. Thank you very much.